Hey, I'm Drew Piscopo. Alongside me is Matt Crumbuck. We're also here with Coach Rez inside the den here for the High Country Grizzlies Coaches Show. Coach Rez, thanks for taking the time to speak with us today.
Appreciate it. Thanks,
man. Yeah, we're here at Boone Saloon. And first, we want to just talk about this past week, obviously, and even before that, going into training camp and how you had to, you know, dwindle down your roster a little bit. I know that was obviously, you know, pretty tough.
Yeah, it was a process. You know, everything we do has a process, and one of the main things is, you know, finding the players and doing the recruiting. And I think the front office and myself, our general manager, William Thompson, and myself did a great job of building the roster. And had 36 going into training camp, and to be able to get that down to the 24, you know, we had to send 12 guys home, so that was tough. But we got the 24. Camp was great. You know, it was a couple 2 weeks long. And, you know, for the most part, we were injury free. And so that was a big deal for us.
So when it comes to cutting, you know, players, what is it that you look for in a player to specifically make that cut, that final 24-man roster?
Well, obviously talent, you know, but the biggest thing with the transition from outside to indoor is how fast they can adapt to the arena game. And guys that, you know, for tryouts, when we try to find guys for camp, guys can't really get it on the fly, then we're just not going to, you know, take the time to try to get them to understand what we're trying to do. So guys that can kind of understand what we're trying to do, you know, working with them in training camp is a little easier to help them transition from outside to inside. So really the guys that can pick it up the fastest is what we look for.
Now with training camp, you didn't have the board set up. Was that difficult to have to, you know, try and get the players to adjust even though they weren't necessarily in that environment that they will be, you know, coming game times?
Right, yeah, it's tough to simulate any game situation. You know, when you're practicing, you're trying to simulate getting ready for the game. The walls is the biggest part of the arena game, and I think that was accumulation of, you know, having a good veteran mix with the team. So they were able to help guys and understand, you know, there's no sidelines, so you can't catch the ball and just run through the cones. So I think it was a little transition for them, but I think with our veteran leadership, you know, we were able to get all the guys on the same page.
Was there anybody that really stood out to you too within the last like week or so of training camp that you, that kind of maybe caught your eye that, you know, ended up making the team?
Well, going into camp, you know, I had my eyes on a DB that we picked up from one of our tryouts, Brandon Fuentes. You know, I was pretty high on him going into camp, and you know, he didn't disappoint. He had a great camp. And turned a lot of heads with his teammates, and his teammates found out that, you know, this kid can play. So that was a big excitement for me, you know, going into the season after training camp. And, you know, he didn't disappoint his first game. Got his first career professional interception Saturday night. So that was awesome.
So, you know, transitioning to the first game, a 62-29 win. What did you guys execute well and to be able to get that victory?
I just think, you know, we've came together pretty quick as a team. You know, we saw that day one, and it was pretty shocking. You know, most teams take a couple weeks to get it together. And, you know, going to the game, it was a great team effort. Our O-line played well, you know, pretty great for our first game. Quarterback, you know, was outstanding. Receivers across the board, I think, I mean, he distributed through about seven different all five receivers got a reception, including the tight end. So, you know, he spread the ball around, and just overall our defense was just awesome for the first game.
Was there any kind of like preparation going into that too? I mean, like, how much did you really know about the Firebirds, and if you knew anything at all?
Well, being the first game, you know, there's no film yet on any of the games. They had their preseason game versus Jacksonville, but that wasn't really shared out. You know, with Coach Damian Daniels, our co-defensive coordinator, he's played with those guys in Columbus and when they were the Albany Panthers, and I've known those guys for a while. So we kind of had an idea of what their game plan was going to be. And, you know, he got word yesterday, you know, from the head coach that, you know, they were surprised. They didn't expect us to be as good so quick.
Talk about, like, one play that really stood out to you in that game as well that you think really started the separation and kind of made it
you know,
clear.
For me, I think it came from the defensive side. We had a fumble. We scooped and scored, and Troy Sanders, you know, former Appalachian State standout here, he got the first touchdown for him, and, you know, that kind of separated the gap and kind of set the tone for us for the rest of the game.
Cool. All right, well, we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be back here in a minute with more of the Coach Rez Coaches Show.
Hi, I'm Bob Brewer, owner of Anytime Fitness and offensive line coach for the High Country Grizzlies.
And I'm Dexter Jackson, wide receiver for the High Country Grizzlies and personal fitness trainer.
We have a new, larger facility with 24/7 access.
Within our training program, we provide a focus on your personal goals for a healthier lifestyle and create customizable training programs.
Come in for a free consultation and get a fitness plan tailored just for you.
Come join us at Anytime Fitness Boost!
When we bought our home at Blue Ridge Mountain Club, we knew that we were buying more than a house. From the moment we drove through the gates, you could sense there was something different about this place, something almost magical. It was in the air, on the trails, on the tongues of all the people that live here. You know, there's a sense of community here that we've never felt anywhere else. Every time we meet someone, get together for a meal, or just pass each other on the trail, we know we're all part of something really special.
Well, we wanted to live somewhere that was, I don't know, felt like we were closer to nature. But we also wanted a place that we would have a community that feels the way we do about life, living, and loving. We were afraid that when we moved here, we wouldn't make the kinds of friends we'd made over the past 30 years. But it's been just the opposite. Our very best friends are here at BRMC, and we are together almost every night. It was so important to us when we were looking for a place to settle that my children, and eventually my grandchildren, could come and explore here, hiking, biking, horseback riding, fishing, swimming. This is the ultimate child's playground and a parent's paradise.
Sometimes when we go on the back deck of our home to watch the sunset above the clouds, the streaks of colors across the mountaintops, it's just overwhelming. Breathtaking, really. I mean, how lucky are we to be here? Well, for us, BRMC really is a gathering place for our family, friends, and the community at large. Whether we're at the Pavilion, the Blue Hole, the Great Lawn, or just hiking the trails on a lazy afternoon, there's no end to the great experiences we have here. My kids love it here so much that we're building another larger home to house the ever-growing family who wants to be here. It's everything you'd want a mountain home to be. People who come here want to stay here. It's the majesty of the mountains and the magic of Blue Ridge Mountain Club.
Welcome back. We are here at Boone Saloon for the High Country Grizzlies Inside the Den with Coach Rez. I'm here with Drew Piscopo. I'm Matt Kronbach, and of course, Coach Rez. And Coach, just kind of wanted to touch on your background a little bit. Where'd you grow up, and kind of where'd you originate, and you know, your maybe a little bit of your football background as well?
Yeah, for sure. You know, I was born in Tacoma, Washington. Great state. I believe I moved to California when I was about in the fifth grade. And that's where I ended up being raised, and went through high school there, played quarterback, played high school football there. Then I went into the Marine Corps after high school, stationed in Lejeune, did two combat tours in Iraq. After that second one, it was time to get out. So we settled down in the Raleigh area once we left Camp Lejeune out of Jacksonville, North Carolina. And, you know, from there I played a couple years at this level, arena football. Started coaching high school football when I got out of the Marine Corps. So those 2 years I played, was going into my third year, got my first real actually coaching opportunity. So I set the minor league football aside and then pursued my coaching career. So, and then I've started coaching arena football. So it's been a blast, been a great experience, built a great network through the years. So, you know, I'm excited for this opportunity that we're in now.
Talk about a little bit some of your past experiences as well, how that's really helped you with the High Country Grizzlies.
Well, the biggest thing that I always turn back to is my military. You know, the being in the Marines and being a combat veteran, you know, those things kind of help prepare me for some of the things that I would encounter as a coach. You know, everyone talks about, the question comes up, how do you deal with the pressure and how do you deal with the adversity? Well, you know, when you got bullets flying your head, you know, real bullets, you know, the coaching thing is just like a kid's playground. So it's not really, the pressure isn't really there, but there is, I love the pressure for excellence. You know, there's always a commitment to excellence, and that's what we try to shoot for. So couple coaching stops here or there, had a couple opportunities in championship games, been pretty successful, but I'm not where I want to be yet as a coach, so we're always trying to learn to be better.
Now, you've held other positions as well, other than just being a head coach in football. How do you also think that's helped prepare you for where you are today?
I think it's been great, you know, for me. I've been in a couple different startup situations. So, again, that was a big deal with the front office, you know, feeling that it was a good fit for us, for myself to be named as the head coach. So, you know, they're doing a great job. Whenever something comes up, you know, they'll ask a question. And so that's pretty cool, you know, to be included in that stuff. I'm in the point now where I don't want to deal with the general manager roles or ownership stuff or anything like that. I just want to coach. And I'm finally in a situation where everything around me is perfect, and now it's up to me to lead the guys and be successful.
That's awesome. One real quick question, too, about, I guess, some of the transition from more of your traditional football to arena football. What's some of the biggest changes, I guess, that you had to make as a coach between the two really different styles of play?
Yeah, just the speed. The speed of the game. I'm an air raid guy outside, so I love to throw the ball. So the arena football and myself fit together. That's just the style of play that I am, and that's what I coach, and that's what I go after. So it was a pretty smooth transition, you know, honestly. And I've enjoyed it, and I look forward to what's to come.
All right, we'll take a quick break, and we'll be back with the sponsor highlight here for the High Country Grizzlies Inside the Den Coaches Show with Coach Rez.
I've coached a lot of football games in my life. The win at Michigan was big for us. When I took that short ride on the shoulders of our team, we knew that we'd done something really, really special. The hard work and dedication and commitment that nobody sees is what leads to great victories. That's the same thing you'll get at Discover Chevrolet. That's the reason I agreed to be their spokesman. Discovery Chevrolet is where relationships matter.
Step away from the exercise cycle and step outside yourself in Boone, North Carolina.
Here at Blackjack, we were voted the best burger in town 3 years in a row. I am originally from Romania. My mother opened this restaurant about 10 years ago, and she passed away last year, and I am here carrying on her legacy. Our story started with, we left Romania, it was a communist country, and we had to run across the border. We had to cross the Danube River on an inflatable boat. Me and my mother was in a boat. I had to swim across, actually. We've been in the United States since 1991. I lived in California since 91 until about 4 years ago when I came here to help her run this restaurant. And like I said, I'm carrying on her legacy. The culture comes into play where all the food here, as I said, not just the burgers, but everything we serve here is cooked to order. And we make a lot of our own sauces in-house. A lot of our, the recipes are unique because they're designed by her. And people love that, people like that. I think we have the best burger, but I want you to come out here and give us a try and let me know what you think.
Welcome back inside the den in the coach's show with Coach Rez, of course, for the High Country Grizzlies. And right now we have Malachi Jones and quarterback Stephen Panasuk, who actually got the offensive player of the game, the Skyline Sky best player of the game, but player of the week as well. And our Carolina West defensive player of the game was Troy Sanders. Unfortunately, he couldn't be here with us this week. So I guess we have this guy here with us, Malachi Jones. He's an okay wide receiver, I guess. But guys, first question, you know, how was the first week? I mean, now you guys actually finally had boards and walls to deal with. What was that adjustment like? I mean, Stephen, obviously you played in arena football before, but obviously a little bit of a transition for you, Malachi.
Yeah, I would say I think the first game went well. You know, finally having that opportunity to play a game with the walls and have the actual, you know, size of the field and things of that nature. I think it went extremely well. Took a little bit of adjusting too, but I think in all, for the guys who haven't played like myself and the other rookies, I think we handled it pretty well. And you know, it showed. We won 62-29 and had a very, very good showing. So you know, we were very pleased with our performance.
Yeah, it was good to see the guys get out there in the walls, between the walls. I think they adjusted well. Spacing was a big thing that we talked about a lot throughout camp, and our spacing was pretty good. Yeah, we got a big win, but, you know, we want to keep improving and keep doing better each week. And I know that we have the talent, even with the young guys, to be able to do that week in and week out.
Stephen, 14 for 18, 201 yards, 5 touchdowns, 1 rushing touchdown. League player of the week, how does that feel?
Feels good, but it's not just me. You know, I have to have the line to block, and they did a great job. They don't get enough love, and I said this in an interview before, they don't get enough love at all. All four of those guys and our fullback did a great job protecting me, and the receivers did a great job getting open and making plays when they got the ball in their hands.
Yeah, it seemed like a lot of points in that game, too, for the limited amount of offensive snaps you guys actually ran.
Yeah, that happens, and that's a credit to the defense, too. You know, the defense, we were on the field maybe a couple plays at a time, and the defense was getting turnovers, and the defense scored a touchdown as well, so those points came from all around. Even in our kicking game, we hit a deuce, which is when you kick off, and if the ball goes through the uprights, you get 2 points. So we were scoring in all facets of the game, and we're going to just try to keep that momentum and keep going forward this weekend.
You know, Malachi, too, you know, you were talking about last week during training camp about kind of getting used to the shorter condensed field and more, you know, working on really stemming routes on that smaller grid. How was that actually going into a game? Did you feel like it kind of came more natural with practice, or what did you, you know, sometimes revert back to the old college days?
I think, you know, it's still an adjustment. You know, I'm still adjusting to it, you know, even now. But just to have the opportunity to see the field live and run on it, and then, you know, for the first time running in tennis shoes or turf shoes, it was the first time I had the opportunity to really play a game in them. So, yeah, and, you know, sometimes I do revert back to what I used to do in outdoor football. I mean, you know, it's just a habit that I'm going to have to break. But, no, I think, I think my transition as far as learning the game and things of that nature has been extremely well. You know, I have my quarterback and the rest of the guys to thank for that, so.
All right, well, thank you guys so much for joining us today. Stephen Panasuk, obviously, quarterback, we wish you guys the best of the luck next week. So we'll take a quick break, and we'll be right back on the High Country Grizzlies Inside the Den Coaches Show with Coach Rez.
So, how's retirement?
Staying pretty busy, actually.
Busy?
Busy.
Honey, look.
Number 18 in the house.
Gets the same thing every time.
You know, I can hear you, right? You know I can hear you, right? I'll be here all week. For your many retirement needs, Nationwide is on your side.
Joel made fresh daily.
Look at you.
Yeah.
Boom.
Oh, 100% mozzarella. Kids are going to love these Hungry Howie's emojis. Hashtag sawsome.
The best part is they're edible.
They're edible? How's that?
Get a meal deal for any budget, or get a medium one topping pizza for $1 with coupon code MEDIUM1.
Hungry? How?
step away from the television, and step outside yourself in Boone, North Carolina. How can something be so close to everywhere you want to be, but also possess the peace and quiet you desire in a true Appalachian mountain setting? That's what you'll find at Swiss Mountain Village, nestled in a tranquil valley just off the Blue Ridge Parkway and very close to downtown Blowing Rock. For over 35 years, Swiss Mountain Village has been a haven for high country guests and families, a place where the relaxing is easy, a place where you can fish from the fully stocked trout lake or just rock your cares away on the front porch. Then, when it's time for high country activities, you are close to everything. Swiss Mountain Village is only just a few minutes from the Blue Ridge Parkway and Moses Cone Memorial Park. Also, just a few minutes to downtown Blowing Rock, Tanger Shops on the Parkway, Appalachian Ski Mountain and other area ski resorts, Tweetsie Railroad, Appalachian State University in downtown Boone, Grandfather Mountain, and many more. Swiss Mountain Village offers cabins made of rough-hewn logs, complemented by a native stone fireplace. The Swiss chalets feature a unique architectural design. The stairway to the loft actually takes you over the stone fireplace. All of the Swiss Mountain properties are completely furnished with towels, linens, complete kitchens, washers and dryers, gas logs, free Wi-Fi, and cable TV. There's also a clubhouse and outside barbecue. 1, 2, and 3 bedroom plus studio units are available, accommodating from 2 to 8 people. Swiss Mountain Village offers 12 beautiful acres that will become your high country home away from home. It's where you and your family will create great memories and a place where you will return to time and time again. To learn more about Swiss Mountain Village, visit SwissMountain.com or call 888-785-1188.
Here at Blackjack, we were voted the best burger in town 3 years in a row. Our story started with we left Romania. It was a communist country, and we had to cross the Danube River on an inflatable boat. Me and my mother was in a boat. I had to swim across, actually. I lived in California since 91 until about 4 years ago when I came here to help her run this restaurant, and like I said, I'm carrying on her legacy. I think we have the best burger, but I want you to come out here and give us a try and let me know what you think.
Welcome back inside the den on the Coach Rez High Country Grizzlies Coaches Show here at Boone Saloon. Coach, as we kind of look forward to next week, your upcoming opponent, what's some of the differences this week compared to last week?
Well, it's a better team. You know, they're very established. I think they're, I mean, I hate to, you know, shorten them years, but I think they're going to their eighth year as a franchise. A veteran quarterback, coach has been around for a long time. Some of those players have been playing for a while. So, you know, it's going to be a much better team than Georgia from an experience standpoint. But, you know, we've had a couple good practices. And so we're excited going into the week, and, you know, we're excited about it. So, I mean, I think it's going to be a good game. It's going to be a great game for our first home game in the Convocation Center. So I'm excited to bring that to Boone.
You've got a guy, Eddie Davis III. He had 3 interceptions last week. Obviously him, but who else are you kind of looking at to be some threats for them?
Well, one of their linebackers, they got a great Jack linebacker, Christian Alvarez. You know, he's pretty active as a Jack linebacker. So that's kind of basically, to explain just on him very quickly, is like a strong safety. plays down in the box, you know, helps underneath and stuff like that and helps support the run. So, he's a big force. One of their good pass rushers that they had, we actually picked him up from Lehigh, so Larry Ford. So this is going to be a big game for him to face the team that he's been with for the last 4 years. So we're pretty excited for what's going to come from that.
Right. Well, from this past week, too, just kind of evaluating the film, obviously the score indicates that you guys played pretty well. But as you know, kind of looking back on it, I'm sure you can pick up some things that you guys want to improve on. What's some of the things that you're really looking for, you know, this week that you hope you do better next week?
A little bit better route running on some things. I think maybe we had 4 incompletions. I think 2 of those were drop balls. We can tighten that up a little bit. In the secondary, losing track of guys, receivers, you know, taking eyes off receivers and putting them in the backfield. And, you know, that's what kind of gave up a couple of passes for us. But again, those are, we got a couple of rookies in the secondary. So, that's going to be expected. But we limited our mistakes, and that's all you can ask for as a coach, you know, with your preparation is we're going to make mistakes, but limit them and not make them in bad situations.
You know, going into the Holmes Convocation Center for the first time this season, obviously, you know, App State Mountaineers, they pack the rock. They make that a raucous place to play at. What do you expect going into Holmes this week?
Well, the biggest thing, we have a winner, you know, coming for our first home game. You know, that was my biggest thing going to Georgia, was I felt that if we can go down there, get a good win, get a big win. I didn't anticipate, you know, the gap of the score of where it was. I mean, I had an idea. You always want to blow the team out, but to be able to do that and to come back home, just the support we had back home on the road, you know, local restaurants were streaming the game. Even Boone Saloon had it here on their big screen. So just to know that kind of excitement here waiting for us when we're on the road, I can only imagine how it's going to be Saturday night. And, you know, we're looking forward to pack it out, and it's going to be a tough place to play, you know, and to jump off the App State, you know, filling the rock. I think we can get to that point where we're packed and we're sold out for our games. And, you know, it's just a great testament of what they've built here in the Boone area with their football program, and I'm excited to just even be in the same words of them as of being together, you know, and having football, so the fans here don't have to wait all the way back around to the next summer for it to start back up, so it can be year-round.
Awesome. Well, Coach, we wish you the best of luck, you know, this upcoming week and really moving forward throughout the rest of the season.
Awesome. Appreciate that.
Yeah, thanks for joining us here on the Coach Rez High Country Grizzly Coaches Show, and we'll see you guys next time.